imaging in C-rectum. Imaging in C-rectum as compared to whole abdomen is something different. In MR rectum, CT is not best. MRI is the best. In case of C-rectum, MRI is the best. Intention to do MRI in C-rectum, we need to know the adequate T categories, the mainly T3 and T4. We should know depth of invasion. We should know extramural invasion, which is one of the prognosticating marker for the disease prognosis. We should know CRM, that is, I have explained, circumferential resection margin. We'll deal detail while doing imaging of the CRM. Peritoneal reflection, I have shown the anterior peritoneal reflection. Below that, it is a low rectum. At the peritoneal reflection on the sagittal film, it is a mid rectum. Above the peritoneal reflection, it's upper rectum. We should know clearly what's happening. We should know nodal involvement, because depending on the node, whether we can go for radiation or no radiation or long course radiation, all things will depend. Response evaluation. We should know response evaluation, because clinical complete response is one of the important modality for wait and watch. And while doing wait and watch, we'll deal this later. But while doing wait and watch, it's also important to know that patient is not getting any recurrence. For that, all thing we should know. These are the 7 characteristic feature on the MRI clinicians should get. But please remain, clarify this. MRI is not a screening for C-rectum. It's a modality which is deciding the further treatment. It is not used for screening. For screening, we are using sigmoidoscopy or colonoscopy. How MRI is important in C-rectum? This is the recent classification has been made by the ISMO, which is still not accepted in NCCN guideline, but at present most logical and more better management has been suggested based on this. This is classifying the rectum into the good, bad, ugly. So few of the thing which may not be in your book, but I am touching the concept, because without touching the concept you won't understand. But sure for you that few of the newer concept also going to be in your exam, you should know and you should understand. It might be little bit heavy, just bear it. If you know the concept, if you read, you will be more thorough with the concept. For that reason, I am going in little bit deep. So the ISMO guideline, or recently based on Mercury guideline, they have given few of the concept. Tumor or CA rectum should be categorized into good, bad or ugly based on the MRI finding. MRI finding T1 to T3, any tumor which is limiting to submucosa or muscularis or mesorectum, that is T1 to T3, or without any node, without extramural invasion, without mesorectal fascia involvement, that is good tumor. Bad tumors are more than 5 mm. I have shown T1, T3A is 1 mm involvement of mesorectum, T3B is 1 to 5 mm, T3C is more than 5 mm. To 15 mm, T3D is more than 15 mm, T3B, that is more than 5 mm, or T4 involving posterior wall of vagina, or extramural invasion, or mesorectal fascia less than 1 mm. Mesorectal fascia, sorry, it should be more than 1 mm. Mesorectal fascia is clear in those scenario. If you are having T3B or C or more, or mesorectal fascia is not involved, but extramural invasion is there, or T4 posterior vaginal wall is involved, is there bad tumor. Ugly tumor are T4 or mesorectal fascia involvement. For your simplicity, T1 to T3 or T3A and B is good tumor. T3, C and D or extramural invasion is a bad tumor. Mesorectal fascia involvement or posterior wall of vagina is involvement is ugly tumor. If you have classified this, according to that, risk of local recurrence also will come. In spite of doing good TME, if you are having good tumor, there is chance of local recurrence from 5 to 10%. If your tumor are bad, which is T3, C and D or extramural invasion, risk is 10 to 20%. If your tumor is having mesorectal fascia involvement or complete other organ posterior wall involvement, other than posterior wall means prostate involvement, bone involvement or seminal vesicle involvement, you are having other organ involvement, the risk of recurrence, local recurrence is 20%. In colon, distant mets is important. In rectum, most of the rectal malignancy come with local recurrence. So all the concept evolve around the local recurrence. So local recurrence risk in ugly tumor is 20%.
Sir,
so,
here, this pre-op CRT is in ugly is long course.
I have not come to that. I'll tell you.
Okay, sorry. Yes.
Good tumor where your local recurrence is less than 10, which is accepted, fairly standard local recurrence is 5 to 10% at present time also for T3 disease, which is accepted. So what they are thinking is, why we should unnecessarily radiate this patient whose local recurrence is 10% if you have done the good TME. So for good tumor, they are recommending only TME, that is total mesorectal excision, which is suffice, which is more than enough. If you are having bad tumor, which is T3, C and D, extramural invasion, local recurrence is 10 to 20%. But this patient needs only sterilization of the local field. For only sterilization of local field, not need of downstaging, downgrading, why we should wait for 3 months? If you are committed for the chemo radiation, you are giving 5 to 6 weeks chemo radiation followed by you are waiting for 6 weeks, means almost 3 months you are waiting. But why you are waiting? You are waiting to take care of local recurrence. But this is the tumor which is having also risk of distant metastasis. You are not at all handling. So unnecessarily you are radiating, unnecessarily you are waiting for longer time. Patient inconvenience is there, cost is there, but also you are missing the chance to give a chemotherapy. So for those patients who is having bad tumor, they are radiating short course for 5 days radiation, 5 gyra, followed by 7 to 10 days waiting, doing PME within 15 days, patient is over. At the pathological specimen, YP is coming as a higher grade, they are giving chemotherapy, otherwise they are stopping there only. So it's fair enough, where functional or quality of life is good, cost is involved is good, patient convenience is good, unnecessary waiting is also cut down. So it is better option, bad tumor. And ugly tumor where your intention, adjacent organ involvement is there, mesorectal fasciae involvement is there, more than 20% local recurrence risk is there. Intention to downstage and downsize the tumor is high need. Those patients, they are giving extensive chemo radiation for 5.5 weeks, that is total 1.8 to 2 gyra every 5 days of a week, completing 1.5 month cycle, then followed by 6 to 8 weeks of waiting, followed by TME, followed by again adjuvant chemotherapy, total duration of perioperative treatment of chemo-RT, that is long course chemo-RT, is going to end by 6 months. So that is only they are giving for T4 disease other than posterior wall, vaginal wall involvement or mesorectal fascia, which is advocated. So that's what it changes the concept. The patient, if you take a T3 as per the NCCN, T3 N plus all goes for the chemo-RT. Those bad and good tumor, which should not go for the chemo-RT. So those patients, as per the MRI, they are classifying the short course treatment or without radiation, whether to go for the surgery. That's what the newer evolving concept. But if you see, whole concept is based on MRI. So MRI is important in case of planning complete CA rectum management. Any doubt on this table, you can ask.
Yes, sir. I wanted to ask that isn't still long course radiotherapy the standard of care as opposed to SCRT?
There is nothing called standard. Few of the people are going for long course, few of the people are going for short course. At present guideline, whatever coming with good evidence, Stockholm 3 trial and other trial in India also, around 25 to 30% of the institute has moved towards the short course. So present guideline, present literature is more favoring based on the particular stage of the disease. So we can think of the particular stage based treatment.
So as you said, sir, T3N1 CA rectum, if is asked in MCU, what to proceed with, it should be NACT RT plus surgery, na?
any CTRT plus surgery.
And if a choice between long course chemo, long course RT or short course, then?
Then as per your book, you have to go for long course. But I am sure if the examiner is updated with current last 2 year guideline, last 2 year treatment modality, he will expect you should get updated. There is something called book-based question. There is something called current concept-based question. These are the practical evolving concept which any exam going candidate should know. If standard question is asked, it's book-based question. Whatever I have taught about the hereditary polyposis, these are book-based question. You should know. If you don't know, it's not knowing. But few of the current treatment-based concept, that also you should know, because it's not new. It's a 2 year old 2017 guideline which has updated. Although MCCN has not updated, but last 2 years, these are the evolving concept. Lot of institutes are changing their concepts, so you should know today, tomorrow, or after time it will come based on your question, what he is expecting, you should answer. But if you are knowing the strategy, knowing the concept, you will better to answer that question.
Fine, sir.
Sir, any other misorectal total misorectal excision, you have to remove only misorectum or the primary tumor also, sir.
When I come to surgical concept, I will tell TME means complete removal of enclosed cavity of mesorectal fascia. When I come to TME, I will explain whole thing, but it is complete mesorectum means rectum is inside, mesorectal fat is outside, fascia is outside. You are taking the bag inside the fascia means inside everything it will come. It will come rectum, it will come node, it will come fascia, it will come fat, all the things which will be taken. But what's exactly TME happening, I will explain later when I touch to the surgical concept of TME.
Yes, sir, here you are telling us, sir, low risk tumor, intermediate risk, high risk. Here, what about the primary tumor, sir? Status of the primary tumor.
That's what I am telling. TME means you are taking the CA rectum along with the mesorectum. It's not okay, only sir. Mesorectum you are saving. You are taking the complete rectum, mesorectum completely along with fascia.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Wherever I am talking TME means I am taking the rectum along with mesorectum. You are not separating your rectum from the mesorectum.
Then I understand, sir.
Okay. So we'll move for the further. So CT or MRI, local staging MRI is better. But nodal staging, MRI CT equal, but MRI is preferred. MRI superior for equivocal liver lesion. If CT, you are seeing the lesion which is not classically understand, MRI is better. Small lesion, unequivocal, equivocal lesion, MRI is better. CT is better for pulmonary mets. 4 to 9% of the CT chest will detect the colorectal mets in the chest. Contrast in rectum, contrast is controversial, because the distance from the rectal wall to the mesorectal fascia, which decide whether you are going directly surgery, less than 5 mm directly surgery, 5 to 15 mm, which will go for your short course RT or long course RT. So distance is changing your whole concept. But if you distend the rectum with the contrast, which will reduce the distance and it will give the fallacy. So rectal contrast for classical description of MRI is not advocated. IV contrast which will upstage the tumor, which is also not advocated. For MRI, rectum without contrast is the standard. Technique, three plane, axial, coronal, sagittal plane, 3 mm cuts. MRI examination may be performed either 1.5 or 3 Tesla. Neither one has proven any superiority. So 3 Tesla is not better or 1 point is poor. Both are equal. Fat suppress technique, you are seeing the mesorectal fascia, you are seeing the mesorectal fat. So to differentiate between the fascia and fat, fat suppress images or fat saturation technique is better. T2 fat suppress images are better. Motion artifact, bowel peristalsis of small bowel may change the your peritoneal. Your peritoneum in the sagittal plane will make a more importance, so that should not get artifact, create an artifact. For that reason, antispasmodic Western countries, they use glucagon. In Indian setting, buscopan, even without this antispasmodic also give. But long duration imaging where your bowel peristalsis will create the artifact to avoid that, either one of the antispasmodic is better. Endorectal coil, stenosis lesion we cannot use, we cannot pass up to upper rectum or sigmoid, it's expensive, availability is in India, no one uses endorectal coil, it's not a standard of care. Without contrast, without endorectal coil, MRI should be done. Axial plane, if you see axial plane, it's not axial plane, it's oblique axial plane. Oblique axial plane which is perpendicular to the rectal wall. For what purpose we take axial plane? We should see the mesorectal evaluation. The axial plane are used for mesorectal evaluation. Coronal plane are used for identifying the relation with the sphincter, relation of lesion with the sphincter. Sagittal plane are used for the relation of the peritoneum. Parameter, 8 parameter has been mentioned in the Shackelford, which has to be answered in whole CA rectum imaging. Mercury trial, which is MRI, mercury trial one, which shows that MRI is the modality for local evaluation, local advanced rectum evaluation, MRI is the modality which has been shown in the mercury trial. Primary tumor evaluation is based on the morphology, semilunar, annular or polypoidal. Presence of mucinous feature also should be mentioned. If you take this image, this is a rectum lumen. This is the rectum lumen. This is a polypoidal lesion, which is the polypoidal lesion. And if you take a, this is the our coronal section. If you take an axial section, this is the lumen. And this is the tumor which is filling. This is the tumor which is filling. If you see this area, you are able to see my cursor?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. This is the mesorectum. This is the lateral mesorectum. This is the mesorectum. If you see this area which is going, this is the thin dark line. This dark line is a mesorectal fascia. You can see the mesorectal fascia. So this is a tumor, polypoidal tumor, which is limited to the bowel lumen, appearing to infiltrate the mesorectum. Mesorectum is infiltrating. Means it may be T2 tumor which is infiltrating the bowel, or it may T3A tumor that is into the mesorectum but less than 1 mm. It's a T3A or T2 tumor. So characteristic of tumor has to be told on MRI. Height of the tumor from anal sphincter, which is seen on the coronal section, if less than 5 mm is low rectum, 5 to 10 mm, mid rectum, more than 10 mm, upper rectum. These are arbitrary with every book, every standards. T stage is important, depth of invasion. Depth of invasion on MRI is more important. It has been seen in mercury trial that depth of invasion, it is also mentioned in your Shackelford also, that depth of invasion less than 0.5 mm on, if you take a MRI, you do the T staging. If you take a depth of invasion on pathology, you do the staging. How much difference we can see is less than 0.5 mm difference is there, which has been seen in mercury trial. Mercury trial, which is the trial which is advocating MRI for the investigation of choice for local staging and also proposing the treatment modality based on MRI finding. So semi-annular tumor, if you see as annular tumor, it will be like this, depth will be there. In those, midpoint is taken as a tumor, means from the tumor we are seeing the margin. So midpoint is taken as a tumor point. From there, we should measure the margin. Polypoidal tumor, stark has taken as a measurement marker. It's a rectal wall. You see, this is a rectum. There may be a tumor. This is a rectal wall. You can see this is a rectal wall. This is a center of the lumen. In the rectal wall, you can see mucosa, submucosa. A differentiation of T1 to T2 is better in endorectal ultrasound. MRI will tell about the mesorectal T3, T4. This is better visualized. Locally advanced, this is better on the MRI. This is a mesorectum. Here, if you see mesorectal fascia, which is going. This is the mesorectal fascia, which is going. For just to know, I just shown. What exactly MRI does is T1, T2. Differentiating T1, T2 is very difficult in MRI. You need high resolution MRI to know. But what is standard MRI is 1.5 Tesla without contrast is a standard MRI. T2 suppressed images we can see. Those MRI, differentiating the T1, T2 is difficult. All T1, T2, what they will tell, it's a limited to bowel lumen. But T3 in mesorectum involvement less than 1 mm, beyond the muscularis is T3A, 1 to 5 mm T3B, 5 to 15 mm T3C, more than 15 mm is T3D. If you are taking the T4, peritoneal reflection is T4A, involvement of adjacent organ is T4B. So in this tumor, its axial section is, this is a muscularis layer, this is a mucosa, submucosa. It is remitted to submucosa is T1, it's going till the muscularis is T2. Beyond the muscularis is involving mesorectum, this is a mesorectum, is T3A, B, which is A is less than 1, 1 to 5 is B. If you are seeing involving more on the deeper, more than 15 mm C and D, more than 15 mm D. Now we can see that this is a mesorectum, this is envelope. You are seeing axial section, this is envelope. This envelope is there, the tumor is coming, either it is touching or it's very close to the tumor. That distance between the tumor and fascia is less than 1 mm, that is called a positive CRM, those positive CRM. If you are having peritoneal cavity near, if infiltration of peritoneum is T4A, which is possible in case of T4A, is possible only in case of mid and upper rectum where peritoneum is present. T4B is organ involvement, either prostate, seminal vesicle, vagina, or which may be bladder, which may be involvement of the posterior sacrum, that is T4B. If you see coronal section, T1 is limited to submucosa, T2 is going to the muscle, T3 MRF positive, which is mesorectal fascia. This is mesorectal fascia here, posteriorly mesorectal fascia here. If it is touching the mesorectal fascia, T3 MRF positive. If it is less than 1 mm from the mesorectal fascia, then also it is a mesorectal fascia involvement. That is a mesorectal fascia involved. If you are involving the bladder, posterior seminal vesicle T4B, if you are touching the peritoneal reflection, peritoneum is T4A. These are the T staging, which is classically we can see on the MRI. For knowing the peritoneal invasion T4, we need a sagittal T2 weighted images. Sagittal images mainly for peritoneal reflections. Peritoneal reflection can be deficited, hypointense line contacting the bladder, anterior superior aspect of the rectum. On anterior superior aspect of the rectum or posterior superior aspect of the bladder, we can see the peritoneal reflection. In this area is a peritoneal reflection and this is a tumor. We can see more better on the sagittal view. A T4D is involvement of surrounding organ, vagina, prostate, bladder or seminal vesicle. If you see here, this is your part of the vagina and this is a part of the rectum. Rectum is invading the part of the uterus. That's a infiltration, T4B disease. If you see axial section, this is a rectum, this is a mesorectum, this is a surrounding. Here you can see the mesorectal fascia. On anterior aspect, this is a posterior aspect, this is anterior aspect, this is a lateral aspect. Anterior aspect here may be a prostate or maybe a uterus. This is uterus. This tumor is invading into the uterus, means it is the T4B tumor. If you see this tumor, this area you can see bladder, this area you can see rectum. The contrast in the rectum, which is going into the bladder, this is a fistula into the urinary bladder, this is T4B disease. If you see this disease, this is a vaginal area, this is the rectal area, this is the polyphidal lesion in the mid or upper rectum. There is some connection is there with the vaginal wall. If subsequent image, if you see, this is the stent we have placed into the rectum. Usually upper or mid rectum stent can be placed, lower rectum stent is not advisable. If you see further after 3 month image, there is a still fistula is there, but obstruction has been relieved. The prostate seminal vesicle, if you see the rectum, this is a rectal wall tumor, here is a mesorectum. If you see, this is a seminal vesicle and this area is a prostate, this is a bladder. The rectum to the prostate, there is no line in between, complete continuation is there. It's an involvement of seminal vesicle and prostate. Extent of tumor and its relation to the mesorectal fascia. On MRI, mesorectal fascia is high intensity, is the high signal intensity on both T1, T2 image. Mesorectal fat surrounded by mesorectal fascia, which is fine, low signal intensity. A CRM involved, primary tumor, extramural invasion, metastatic node, tumor deposit. CRM is not only, I have shown you CRM, again I will see, it's not only a tumor which determines the CRM. Anything, it may be a tumor, it may be a node, it may be a mural invasion, or maybe a tumor deposit, which is closest to the circumferential resection margin. And from that, whatever distance, if distance is less than 1 mm, involvement more than 1 mm is clear. So for CRM, all four are advisable. Whatever closest, that is tumor, extramural invasion, metastatic node, deposit. I will show in next image. CRM is positive taken if less than 1 mm. Your MRI image or pathological report shows that the margin between the tumor or node or mesorectal or extramural invasion or tumor deposit is less than 1 mm from the fascia, we is told as a CRM positive. CRM threatened, this is taken from the shackle fold. Threatened CRM means from the fascia less than 2 mm, you are very close, but 2 mm distance is there. That is called threatened CRM. And low rectal tumor, violation of intraspintric plane in lower rectum other than circumferential resection margin or mesorectal fascia. Also, they are considered a violation of intraspintric plane is considered as CRM, or levator involvement is considered as a positive CRM. Now, it is a classical which shows the our mesorectum rectum. This is the rectum. This is the wall of the rectum. You see classically muscular wall. Thin mesorectum is there. It might be a male patient, very thin mesorectum. Rectum. Here you can see your bladder. Here you can see bladder, seminal vesicle. So you can denote the mesorectum. This is a mesorectum. This is the fascia. The circumferential envelope around the mesorectum is mesorectal fascia. Usually mesorectal fascia is thick in the posterior, little bit less on the lateral, very thin in the anterior. Once you go down and down, it becomes more and more, more thin. Mesorectal fascia completely circumferential, only low rectum. And as there is no low rectum below the anterior peritoneal reflection, mid or upper rectum, there is a peritoneal reflection is there. Complete mesorectum circumferential in lower rectum. Mid and higher rectum apply only on non-peritoneal surface. Let's see this image. We can see it doesn't apply for the peritoneal surface. I clarified earlier only whenever there is a peritoneal surface, it's peritoneal margin. Whenever there is non-peritoneal surface, it's called mesorectal fascia. If you see low rectum below the peritoneal reflection, there is no peritoneum. So anywhere this circumference, anywhere this surrounding circumference is mesorectal fascia. This whatever yellow we are seeing is mesorectum. This brown whatever we are seeing is muscle. This inside what you are seeing, mucosa, submucosa, this is lumen. So circumferentially complete present in low rectum. In mid rectum, anterior part, the peritoneum will come and touches where it is a peritoneal margin. Rest of the area where peritoneum is not there on axial suction is the mesorectum. Mesorectal fascia means here you are seeing this is mesorectal fascia. In case of upper rectum, lateral and anterior covered by peritoneum. So rest of the non-peritoneal area is mesorectal fascia, that is called circumferential resection margin. So because of so much of complexity, it will create a lot of confusion. But try to understand bit of pieces. It will be useful when you read again. You will get a lot of more clarified thoughts. T3 tumor. Again, we'll come to T3 because all CA rectum treatment, what basic concept is, all T3 are not same. All T3 should not give us same treatment. You should differentiate T3 into different type of T3. Depending upon that, we can avoid the radiation, or we can give a quick radiation, or we can give a long radiation. So T3A less than 1 mm from the muscularis means muscle beyond the muscularis propria. 1 mm is A, 1 to 5 mm is B, more than 5 mm, 5 to 15 mm is 5 to 15 mm is T3C, and more than 15 mm beyond the muscularis is T3D. MRF, I explained the mesorectal fascia involvement. No tumor within 1 mm, no tumor, no node, no mural invasion, or no tumor deposit, that is mesorectal fascia negative, or involvement is mesorectal fascia positive. let's see MRF negative, MRF positive, what does mean? This is the rectum, this is the muscle layer. Here you are seeing the tumor. Tumor is infiltrating into the mesorectum. White hole mesorectum you are seeing. So you see here, this margin. You see here, this margin. Everywhere you go, this is the uterine part. Everywhere you go, you are seeing the clear margin. Means it's a MRF negative. Mesorectal fascia is clear. Means your tumor reaching to the mesorectum, but it's not involving the mesorectal fascia. MRF negative, it might be T3A or T3B disease. MRF positive, how can you see this tumor, which is the circumferential, which is involving the right lateral, anterior, posterior, and you see this mesorectal fascia, mesorectum. You see the mesorectal fascia, this fascia, it's an envelope. But if you see here, it's touching to the mesorectum, means it's a MRF positive.
Sir, CRM positive also,
yeah,
same thing as
MRF positive or CRM positive, both are same.
Okay, sir.
Are you getting or everything is going above the head?
So, getting, sir.
Should I go ahead with this same pace?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I will finish after that. If you are having doubt, we can take. Everything is not needed. But if you listen, you understand few of the concept, it will be easy you to read when you are reading to understand the concept. So for that reason, I am taking little bit detail with every image. Okay. At the end of that this presentation, you can ask about the imaging if you are having any doubt. So you take this image. In this image, image quality is not that great, but I have picked up lot of image. I have picked up from the sacral fold. If examiner want to take your MR rectum image only, he has to follow these images. For that reason, I have taken. So you see here, this is a muscle wall. This tumor is left lateral and posterior. Which is the muscle wall is here. This mesorectum, this is a part of mesorectum, this is a part of mesorectum, anteriorly less. So this tumor is beyond the muscle, which is going into the mesorectum. This is fatty plane, this is a white fatty plane. It is going the mesorectum. So it is a T3 tumor, which may be A, B, C, we'll decide later. It is going far beyond, it may be C or D. If you see here mesorectal fascia, it is coming here. If you see here, mesorectal fascia is here. Tumor is very close to mesorectal fascia, means it is MRF positive. But you can identify here, this is one of linear structure, which is different from this tumor, but the lumen is filled with tumor, linear structure, that is mural invasion. So there is a tumor, which is T3 with mural invasion. From mural invasion less than 1 mm, we can tell it is a T3 tumor, mural invasion is positive, and MRF is, CRM is positive or negative? Hello?
Positive.
CRM is positive. Again, another finding also we can see here. So tumor is here, another one, some tissue is there. It's not tumor, it's outside the tumor, it's a nodal tissue. You can see the nodal tissue. So we try to see the circumferential resection margin. That's circumferential margin, that mesorectal fascia. Here, see mesorectal fascia is going. From this, it's appear more than 1 mm. So it's not going to consider. What's our definition of CRM is? A knee tumor, node, a mural invasion or tumor deposit, which is closest, we should see how much distance. It is not qualify for CRM positive. Already we are having CRM here positive, so we are not bothered, but it is a lymph node. So we go down, come here. If you see here, this node is also very much close. So even if it is negative, this is going to be positive. So either if you take mural invasion, either you take a node, our CRM is becoming positive, means it's a tumor as clinically T3 plus or T3D with mural invasion, with nodal positivity N plus, with MRF positive. This patient definitely will go for long course chemo T as per your MRI picture.
Sir, mural invasion is invasion of tumor, I mean liver animals.
Mural invasion is nothing but vascular invasion, mural invasion, a extramural invasion is vascular invasion. Vessel is there in the mesorectum. There is a fat, there is a node, there is a vessel. In the mesorectal vessel, if involved, that is called extramural vascular invasion. That is mural, extramural vascular invasion. Peritoneal reflection is also important landmark. We have seen peritoneal reflection, which is seen on the sagittal plane. The peritoneal reflection will decide whether it's a low rectum, upper rectum, or also it will be the T4A disease, T4B disease. For that, rectal peritoneal reflection is important. On axial section, which is seen Siegel sign, normal peritoneal reflection of V-shape, linear structure, recognized as a Siegel sign on axial section. You see, these are the sagittal section. This red mark is the peritoneal reflection. So from the rectum, we can see the peritoneal reflection, how much is going, depending upon that, we can decide. This is a peritoneal reflection. See peritoneal reflection, this is a bladder, this is a rectum, this is a peritoneal reflection. So we should be able to understand. See here, peritoneal reflection is going down and coming up. Means it is a rectouterine pouch. This is a uterus, it is a pouch, rectouterine pouch. See here again, the peritoneal reflection is forming like this. This is the Siegel sign, V-shape sign. This is a V-shape sign. This is mesorectum, mesorectum, rectum, and this is a V-shape sign is forming. Here also, this is a V-shape sign is forming. V-shape sign is forming. Mesorectum, in the mid-rectal part, you are seeing the peritoneum is forming the Siegel sign on the axial sections. In fact, oblique axial section, because usually we'll take oblique axial section. The presence of EM, extramural vascular invasion, in the mesorectal vessel, vein involvement of the tumor is also one of the critical factor, which is a poor prognostic marker. Imaging finding EMVI include irregular expansion of the vessel, loss of normal vascular void, intraluminal tumor signal intensity, continuous or separate from the main tumor. It may be same with the tumor. Last we have seen distant from the tumor. Here you can see this is a mesorectum. You can see mesorectal fascia. This one is a mesorectum fascia, mesorectal fascia, mesorectal fascia. This is a tumor. This is invading into the mesorectum. Only one longitudinal streak kind of thing. So this is continuous vessel. This is extramural invasion into the mesorectal fascia is there. Mesorectal fat is there. This is tumor with EMVI positive. EMVI itself is a poor prognostic marker. It should be noted, it may be continuous or it may be distant from your rectal cancer. So 30 to 40% of rectal cancer associated with EMVI. Non-contrast imaging is the standard for EMVI. There is no need of contrast. And it predicts that poor survival of the patient. Fivefold increase in local recurrence and distant mets if there is a vascular, extramural vascular invasion is there. Accurate assessment of the lymph. Accurate assessment of the lymph node status is also important. MRI shows low accuracy for distinguishing positive or negative lymph node. In fact, rectal lymph node positivity or negativity based on single character, size character. What we use, other node is more than 1 centimeter size, means metastatic, which is not applied for the rectal, mesorectal nodes. So size criteria, if you tell only size criteria, we may be very low accuracy on MRI. But for nodal assessment of MRI, not only size, signal intensity characteristic, signal intensity, and also counter, border counter are used. So let's see this. N stage, characteristic, indistinct border, heterogeneous node or rounded shape. Oval is normal, homogeneous is normal, distinct border is normal. Indistinct border is there, heterogeneous is there somewhere, some hypodense, hyperdense, hypodense, hyperdense. Rounded shape tumor, which is oval is normal, rounded is malignant. If 3 out of the 3, you are having the short axis diameter is less than 5 mm, either of the 3, all the 3 malignant characteristic, rounded, heterogeneous, indistinct is there, that suspicious of the malignant tumor, malignant node. If 5 to 9 mm, either of the 2, if there, it's suspicious of the malignant node. More than 9 mm, Shackelford has mentioned as a 8 mm, it's always suspicious that it's a metastatic node. Node are mentioned, no suspicious, node 1 to 3 more than 4. Clinically, we can classify as this N1, N2. See this image. This is the center of the lumen. This is the muscular layer. This is the mesorectum. Here it is a mesorectal node, mesorectal node. Distinct node in the mesorectum is mesorectal node. And if you see counter, it's a circular, indistinct border, not distinct border. It may be around 5 to 6 mm. So it can be a metastatic node. Extramural node. It's not in mesorectum, outside the mesorectum also node. If any extramesorectal node is there, that is the clear indication for long course chemo RT. And also it may need a extra mesorectal node, a lymph node excision may be also needed because it's a cause for local recurrence. Radiation and surgical panning should be include suspicious extramesorectal node. If you are having suspicious node, it has to be taken, or if you are planning for radiation, it has to be included in the radiation field. So if you see this tumor, in this tumor, outside the mesorectum, one node is there. That is the extra our right inguinal node. It might be a low rectal tumor having a right inguinal node. MRI recording should identify distance of tumor, age, and encroachment. If you are having low rectal tumor, you should know the CRM doesn't only mean the mesorectal circumferential margin. It's also from the levator. Levator means pelvic floor margin also you should know. So it may help to decide feasibility of the sphincter preservation, whether we can go for sphincter preserving, whether we can we cannot go for sphincter preserving. So here another concept of this sphincter preserving. Sphincter preserving means the rectum is having anal sphincter. Whether we can do the rectal surgery without touching the sphincter with oncological radicality, or we need to cut the sphincter, that's a question we need to answer while doing the rectal surgery. That's a sphincter preservation will give the good quality of life. So we should think of rectal sphincter preservation. So for sphincter preservation, we should be having CRM negative, means from the levator, rectum, the tumor is above 1 mm is there. We are having nice plane from the levator, which will give the sphincter preservation. Recurrent rectal tumor, incidence of local recurrence after TM is less than 5%. 5 to 10 is local recurrence rate after proper TME. TME is total mesorectal excision. MRI is valuable in recurrent rectal cancer because it's defined the extent of recurrence. Where recurrence is happening, it will tell. Determine the resectability, whether we can resect or we can't resect, which will told by the MRI. So which is needed MRI properly. So this line I have taken because it's appeared for me as MCQ. It's not related with radiology. It's related with pathology of the rectum. Precise radiopathological correlation require pathological specimen should be taken in Breitlove technique as a put forward quick. So what he is talking, you should not cut. What we do is surgical specimen, we long axis, we cut and we see. What this mercury trial is telling, Breitlove technique means axial you should cut and you should assess where it is going. So better technique to cut the specimen is Breitlove technique, not the flayed open or along the long axis. Just remember Breitlove technique is important for MRI pathological cutting of the specimen in case of the C rectum.
MRI, please repeat the previous slide.
Breitlove technique means you cut
the previous one.
This one.
Yes.
A recurrent rectal tumor. Incidence of local recurrence after proper TME as per Bell yield is less than 5%. So 5 to 10% is acceptable after proper TME. In spite of this, also we get the recurrence. 5% means we'll get the recurrence, local recurrence. Once we have local recurrence, MRI is most valuable because the extent of the local recurrence, which is better assessed by pelvic MRI, and also whether it can be resected or it's adherent to the lot of organs, which will better assess by the MRI. So MRI is more important.
Thank you, sir.
MRI regression gating. So if this concept will come, you are given chemo RT and you want to know whether responding or not responding, around 50% clinical response, around 20% pathological response. Those concepts I will talk later in wait and watch policy. So MRI regression grading, that is grade one, you are having low intensity, complete fibrosis, tumor has replaced by fibrosis, and there is no residual intermediate signal. Intermediate signal means your tumor signal. Tumor is not there, only fibrosis means it is a very good response. Two is fibrosis is there, but there is minimal residual intermediate signal is there. Three is substantial tumor signals, but there is no predominant fibrosis. Four is predominant tumors with low fibrosis. Five is tumor appear unchanged from the baseline. So if you take more of fibrosis, no tumor cell is a good response. Little bit tumor cell with fibrosis. Fibrosis means low intensity. Intermediate signal intensity means tumor cell. Minimal intermediate intensity is 2. And if you are having tumor unchanged from the baseline is poor response. So you should identify the proper response, and this response criteria is used for further assessing how much response has come and whether we can take this patient for wait and watch where we are not doing surgery, or we can take it for the surgery which we assess. So 80% of volume reduction is also one of the favorable response for after neoadjuvant therapy. See, there is a lung mets, liver mets, we can see liver mets. And now few of the images of the endo ultrasound we can see. Ultrasound based on the echogenicity. Echogenicity, tissue has a high fluid content appear black. Tissue with a less interface tissue, less fluid density appear as a white. Smooth muscle, a high fluid content appear black. And skeletal muscle appear white. These are the simple concept. We'll go directly for the imaging. What they will do is, it is a Bainon 5-layer model for ultrasound, rectal ultrasound. Now what they do is, they put a transducer inside, and along with that water filled balloon will be there, and then they will see where which layer, how they are seeing. So a transducer at the center image T, and fluid filled balloon at the central black. This black, whatever we are seeing, it's a fluid filled balloon. To get the proper imaging, they will fill the balloon, and from there they will see. First hypoechoic white line is interface between balloon and mucosa. This first white line, this white line is a balloon and mucosa interface. Second, hypoechoic black. Back is a hypoechoic line, means this black line is muscularis mucosa. Middle hyperechoic line, which indicate this is a white line, is submucosa. Later black line indicate muscularis propria. Last white line, which indicates the interface between the muscularis propria and perirectal fat. Ultrasound staging, based on ultrasound feature, they are also classified as a submucosal involvement T1, invading to the muscle T2, same like a routine staging they will do. So these are the images I purposefully taken. Suppose one image they throw, you should know what's happening. Here if you see, white line is patent, nothing has happened to white line, but something is bulging, but it is distinct, not infiltrating. So this is a tumor, white line is intact, indicating the submucosal is not involved. So this will be the T0, some villous tumor is there, benign tumor, which is hypoechoic tumor is there, which is not involved in the white line, that is the T0 tumor, that is benign tumor. In this layer, if you see, hole is disturbed, it's a first white line, black line, white line. It goes beyond that white line. So this is the middle white line is disrupted. Expansion of outer back line has happened. So this is the tumor which is showing the submucosa and into the muscularis propria. And outer white line is intact, indicating tumor is T2, means invading into the muscle. Outline is maintained, means T2 lesion is there. I am also not expert, but I am trying to correlate you so that if image comes to you, you should have some idea. And if they want to take images, they can pick up from the whatever images shown to you in the second fold. You are seeing all the images I have taken from the second fold. Once you go back to the book, you just see the image, you will have some pictorial idea. If you see this tumor has completely gone beyond. It's some central transducers and this first black line, white line, and then this tumor is gone beyond. It's a T3 tumor. If you see this tumor, it's tumor completely gone beyond. There is nothing characteristic we are seeing here only. So it is T4 tumor going into the vaginal wall. If you see this tumor, all things are intact, but there is a some hypodense structure outside, that is a nodal metastatic node. Imaging for distant mets, CT for the chest, 4 to 9% colorectal lung mets will be identified. Imaging of the abdomen performed by CT or MRI, 20 to 34% of colorectal cancer may have synchronous liver mets. PET is not indicated for routine preoperative evaluation of the CA rectum. PET CT should be only used when there is equivocal finding on the CT or patient with strong contraindication of IV contrast. So here finishes our imaging. Anyone has any doubt, we can ask.
Sir, CRM is less than CRM negative is greater than 1 mm. Correct.
Yeah.
Sir, what do you then mean by threatened CRM?
Threatened CRM means it is close, very close. If you are having less than 1 mm distance from the fascia to the tumor or node or mural invasion or tumor deposit, is the involved. Threatened means close. You are, one is close, one is involved. On MRI, you are seeing less than 1 mm means it is involved CRM. That is, the CRM is positive.
Positive.
More than 1 mm is CRM clear. But negative. One concept I came across from, it is not there anywhere, threatened CRM is how much. But sacral fold is particularly mentioned 2 mm. 2 mm means it is closer. Threatened means if you go beyond that, you will have involved CRM. 2 mm distance is threatened CRM.
Okay, sir.
Sir, prior thank you, sir. To doing MRI, we'll do CT test abdomen pelvis, no?
Why?
No, first we'll rule out distant metastasis and then...
yeah, it is a part MRI, and parcel. No? It's part and parcel. It will be combined. If you are not metastatic, local advance, you go for local MRI. But any time, if you want to manage CA rectum, which is not metastatic, locally advanced disease, MRI is mandatory. But few
there was a question that in the distal rectum, a hard nodular growth which is immobile, is palpable. What would be the next investigation? So MRI was there, MRI pelvis, CCT test abdomen pelvis, ultrasound abdomen, or any of the above may be done.
In those scenarios, CT will come to rule out mets is there or not. I think question is still should be clarified. Still more should be clarified. If they are asking, hello?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, if we are given this much only, CT is the answer.
Because it said fixed growth.
Yeah, CT is the answer.
Okay.
Even if disease growth is fixed on the local, then also which organ is involved, which is better assessed by MRI. But considering your question, which will be CT will be answer.
Sir, but definitely MRI needed, na, sir, for surgery.
Yeah, local staging is better with MRI. If you do MR staging, then only you can decide what kind of treatment you need to go, how you have to manage later, and also post-radiation response assessment is also better on MRI. Local staging, MRI pelvis is the better.
So if it's obvious the lesion is in the rectum or in the rectum, It's obvious we can go for directly MRI, you know, sir. So as to view the MRI and then further rule for distant mets.
It's always combined. It's nothing called only MRI. You go for MRI also, you have to do the CT also.
Okay, sir.